So yeah, post board, there's now four cards cost double black. And they're all very good in this matchup, so it would really be nice to have two black, but obviously I'm not mulliganing this hand, not even close. It's a little awkward, the non-synergy between Pillar and Tragic Slip. No one drop, that's interesting. That might be a bad sign, might be a couple emissaries. Just one. Okay, well, so let's see, we can Tragic Slip this, and we could then Pillar the Emissary. Well, yeah, we're just gonna Tragic Slip for sure, so let's get that out of the way. I'm not sure about Pillar yet. Well, we're going to be running out of gas pretty soon if we Pillar, but that means we might just rely on the Huntmaster to flip, which is reasonable, especially with the Putrefy in hand. The downside is that the 2-2 would deal with the Emissary just fine, but I don't want to take any chances, so... So we have plenty of green, we need red. I'll go ahead and get Blood Crypt here. Yeah, I think taking 2 points there would just be a waste. That's really interesting. Just no play. So he's definitely gonna have a burn spell for our Huntmaster. But that's really confusing. I mean, he could just have all burn and all 3 and 4 drops. Skullcrack. Okay. He boarded in. Okay, yeah. I don't know if that's normal, but I guess with Thragtusk and Huntmaster. That's a good draw for the future. Let's see. I would like to I could flip the Huntmaster. Flip the Huntmaster, deal 2 to him, untap, play 2 spells to flip it back. That seems pretty reasonable. Yeah, definitely. He probably has a Searing Spirit, but like this is still the best thing I could possibly do. Okay, sweet. Didn't have it. That's really good then, because we're gonna get as much advantage out of this Ravager as we can. There's a good chance he has another Reckoner. Mizzy Mortis is really awkward against that. Hopefully I draw another spell I can cast in addition to Putrefy. Oh, he's gonna double Pillar. I guess that's fine. Okay, well, we were actually gonna draw the like one of the best cards to flip the Huntmaster back over with. I guess it's just one of the best cards here. Anyways, we're going to wolf run it for 3 next turn. And he's not even going to have a skull crack, it looks like. Oh, he drew a Searing... I could have drawn that last turn. So he drew that one of the last 2 turns. That's too bad. I don't really want to suicide my wolf, because I would like to be able to kill him with wolf run and wolf. So we want another blood crypt. Yeah. Now that we don't have Garouk, we can probably get blood crypt every time. Yeah, so we want him to either attack. We just want to play a creature, really. We don't care if he attacks or not. We prefer he doesn't attack. And then we can get them out of the way. And try to kill him. Okay, I figured he had another Reckoner. So our wolf is going to die. Do we play Thrag Tusk first here? So you can block the Emissary. If he deals 4 to us rather than the wolf, I don't think that really puts us in any danger. Just yet. Unless he had a Skullcrack for the Thrag Tusk. So if I Thrag Tusk now, I would take 3, be at 14, then cast Amazing Mortars. He'd be able to kill the Thrag Tusk if he wanted to with the Reckoner. But that's not really significant to me. And I guess if we wait, we might also get another creature, so let's do it. The remainder of his hand should logically be potentially another Reckoner, possibly a Skullcrack. Yeah, this is better. If he could have another Reckoner, which is possible, I really want to wait in the Mortars, because if I just kill the Reckoner now and let him kill the wolf or to my face, then play Thrag Tusk, if he has another Reckoner, then we're just stalemated. Well, technically, he'd be at the advantage, so. And this way, we might get another creature. And obviously, if it's the Reckoner, that'd be good. Because we'd end up with the Beast at the end of it. So he attacked and did nothing. That's kind of interesting. I'm probably getting Skullcracked. I definitely want to attack. I don't want to play the Mortars first in this situation. Not anymore. So let's see. I'll attack him for 7. He probably takes it. If he takes it, I could... Let's see. Mortars the Reckoner. He probably deals 4 to me, I go to 10. I play Nighthawk. He probably Skullcracks me, I go to 7. And he's at 9 when I have 9 power plus Wolf Run in play. Okay, he blocks. I think the play that I devised is still the line. I could have Wolf Run for 1 and just played Nighthawk, let him have the Reckoner. That way I can still have it for Overload next turn. I'm going to do it now. I think if he had a creature, he would have played it. 5, 6, 7. I can present lethal exactly next turn unless he kills the Thragtusk. And if he kills the Thragtusk, we know that we're in great shape. Okay. It really does take a lot to beat this deck. We had the Huntmaster that flipped, the Thragtusk, and two Nighthawks. Oh, he did have another Reckoner. Or drew it, maybe. Ooh. 3-6. That's a big no-no. So if we attack their beast, he'd trade and then kill the Nighthawk. Obviously, that's bad for us. Actually, I guess I could have actually bonfired there. He would have to have killed a creature. I think it's still better this way. We have with bonfire in hand and, you know, us at 20, it seems a little better. Okay. Yeah, no changes. I almost feel like I should have had one Garuk on the play. Probably not. Definitely not on the draw, so.